There's a shortage of veterinarians and vet techs in Arizona and around the country. The American Association of Veterinary Medical Colleges says it would take 50,000 vet techs to fill the current nationwide shortage. Western Maricopa Education Center, or West-MEC, is looking to help address the issue. And joining us now, Hailey Adams, an instructor at West-MEC, and also with us, Sedona Price, a student at West-MEC. Good to have you both here. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for inviting us.
Hailey, we'll start with you. How bad is this vet shortage?
It's pretty bad.
How'd it get that way?
Pretty bad.
What happened?
I think there's a lot of different factors. The veterinary field is very emotionally and physically taxing. They also don't make a lot of money. So a lot of veterinarians and veterinary technicians leave because they can make more money elsewhere. Both career paths have a lot of debt too.
Yeah.
So if you put that on top of that and on top of that, it causes a lot of exit in the field.
Are the shortages something new or has it been building for a while?
I've been in the field for 20 years and I think it's kind of been consistently that
really?
Way.
Really? It's always been that way.
Yeah, so I think it's building and getting worse, but it's always consistently been short.
And Sedona, you kind of want to get into this line of work here. What got you interested?
I've always been interested in animals and helping them. And then West-MEC has just helped me see what I actually want to do in the vet field.
How do they do that? What would have been involved in?
We have our own clinic at West-MEC where we have animals from Halo come in and we get to do intake and surgery on them. And it just shows you what it's like to actually work in a clinic.
Yeah. Is it what you expected?
Not really.
How so?
It's really cool to see all the process. There's a lot that goes into doing a surgery on an animal or doing an intake on an animal. It's obviously in a clinic it's a day-to-day thing, but we take a whole week to do it, and we get to really get to know our animals and start to see their personalities come out.
Yeah, and Hailey, that's what we're talking about here. Mm-hmm. Learning, this is the process. You got to learn this, huh?
Exactly, yes. Yeah, they get a ton of hands-on experience throughout.
Yeah. So domestic animals, exotic animals, large animals?
So we have three different campuses at West-MEC. All three campuses have dogs and cats that they focus on primarily. There's a little bit in exotic animals, but our South West campus in Buckeye, they have an extra large animal component.
And as far as kind of Sedona referred to this, assisting vets in surgery, that mm-hmm. goes on, running lab tests, mm-hmm. obtaining vitals.
Yep.
All that stuff goes on with the students.
We do, yes. And then just basic husbandry, since those animals live with us for a week.
Yes.
They learn how to feed them, the proper food. They learn how to clean and care for them. And then they also do some training, too, which is really awesome.
I saw that externships mm-hmm. are offered. What's an externship?
So an externship is where a student actually goes and works out in an animal hospital. We require 100 hours, and that allows our students to sit for their certification exam at the end of the program. So they're actually working with us, building the foundation of those skills, and then they go out to the clinics and they hopefully build those skills further and they see more things while they're out at externship.
Have you done an externship?
Not yet.
Not yet, huh? So you're building toward that.
Yeah.
This is not just, how to be around an animal. It's part of your career. I would imagine resume building is involved, making sure you get all the right things. Is that true?
Yeah, we at the beginning of the school year, we built our resumes and we did mock interviews to prepare us for when we actually go to our clinics and interview for our jobs.
Yeah, and college credits, are they involved here as well?
It's high school credits.
But can college credits be involved
so
too?
So we do have a partnership with Mesa Community College and also Pima Medical Institute, where students that want to go the veterinary technician pathway, they actually can enter those programs a little bit ahead. So they don't automatically get those credits, but if they decide to go one of those programs, they don't have to take those classes.
That's a good point you brought up. There's vet techs and there's veterinarians. Mm-hmm. What's the difference here?
So the best way to kind of compare it is veterinarians are doctors. Veterinary technicians are registered nurses. And then our program prepares veterinary assistants, which are similar to certified nurse assistants or CNAs.
Interesting. So mm-hmm. there's a certification process involved?
Yes.
And how is that involved?
So the certification process is a little different for all three of the pathways. Veterinarians, get their doctorate degree. Veterinary technicians, and it depends on what state that you live in. Arizona's a little bit different. You can actually work in an animal hospital and be a veterinary technician without any formal education.
Mm-hmm.
But for instance, I'm a certified veterinary technician, so I've got a little bit more background and I've taken that certification exam. You would need a two-year associate's program to sit for that test.
Interesting.
And then veterinary assisting, it's a national certification, but it's not required throughout the state. So really, it's resume building and experience that benefits our students.
And so before we go, Sedona, I got to ask you, what's your favorite part of the program so far?
That's hard. I think working with the animals, definitely. Doing the intake and getting to know them.
Yeah.
Working with them.
Do you have to kind of keep your emotions in check sometimes?
Yeah.
Is that difficult to do?
Sometimes. Yeah, because we had these puppies who came and lived with us for 2 or 3 months, and getting try not to get attached to them.
Oh boy, I'll bet.
While we took care of them and like nursed them.
Yeah. Well, it sounds like a great pro. Congratulations and good luck on your career path there. And Hailey, thank you so much for joining us and talk to us about West-MEC and this veterinarian program. Sounds fun.
Yes, it's fun.
Good to have you both here.
Thank you.
Thank you.